I'm Rob Atkinson. I lead a think tank in Washington, D.C. called the Information Technology and Innovation Foundation, ITIF. And we work with policymakers all around the world on helping them shape effective innovation policy, including digital policy. So in the U.S. and a number of other countries, economists have found that innovation and technological change accounts for over 80% of economic growth. So if a country wants to grow, as Brazil wants to and needs to, it's really going to need to embrace technological innovation. And today, that means digital innovation is one of the core components of that. You know, at one level, the biggest obstacle to innovation in a country is countries have to decide what side of progress they're on. Do countries like innovation? Do they want it? Do they think it's generally a good thing and they want to embrace it, which is really where, for example, China is, where I believe the United States is, and many countries are, or do they see it more as a threat and want to slow it down and regulate it and constrain it? And I think for Brazil, the central question is, does Brazil see the future as an optimistic thing that they want to embrace and move forward in and perhaps even lead in certain areas? Or do they see it as something that's fearful and being trying to control it and slow it down? In our view, the optimistic approach is the better one. You get better outcomes for your citizens and your country. So the Internet of Things means basically little teeny sensors that are very cheap that are connected to the Internet, and then companies and organizations can analyze that data to make significant improvements in how they go about producing or providing a product or service. So increasingly, everything is going to be connected to the Internet. Your cars are connected to the Internet, your refrigerator, all sorts of things. And those devices have to be secure, because if they're open to attacks, they can obviously degrade performance or they can lead to information and privacy problems. So cybersecurity has to be built in, but also means that individuals have to take responsibility and practice good cyber habits. For example, make sure your password is super complicated. Don't write your password down on a sticky note and put it on your laptop. Use password managers. Make sure that when you have your operating system or your software that it automatically updates for patches and other kinds of fixes. If individuals do that, then you know they'll be pretty secure.